Many new Windows computers come with two hard drives, a smaller solid-state drive that contains Windows, and a secondary, larger drive for storing data. The picture on the screen right now is a perfect example of that. We have a 256GB hard drive as the main drive, the C drive. And then we have a 1TB secondary drive, the E drive. The problem with this setup, however, is that all of the normal folders for a user, like contacts, desktop, downloads, documents, etc., are stored under the user folder in Windows. If we allow that to continue, the smaller drive will get filled up very quickly. What we want to do is change location settings so that when things are saved under the different folders, like downloads, they will automatically save to the secondary drive. In the case of our example, it's labeled E, Data. In this video, I'm going to show you how to change the location of the various folders under a user's name. I'll slowly show you one or two of them so you get the idea of how to do it, and then I will speed up the whole process. When we get down to just the OneDrive folder, I'll explain what happens there. We're going to start with the Contacts folder. We right-click on it and we find Properties. Next, we left-click on Properties. Across the top, we'll see various tabs: General, Security, Sharing, and so forth. The tab we want to look for in all these examples is the Location tab. We're going to click the Location tab. When we do, we can see that, currently, the Contacts folder is on the C drive under Users, under Beverly. In this case, we want to move that because we don't want things stored there. What we're going to do is click up at the beginning of the location line. We're going to delete the letter C and replace it with the letter E. Keep in mind that on your computer, your secondary drive might not be the E drive. You would use the letter of your secondary drive, whether it's the E drive or G drive, whatever the letter is, that's the letter you're going to put in on this line. Once I've changed the letter, I'm going to click OK. When I do that, I'm going to get a pop-up that says that that folder does not exist. Would I like to create it? Naturally, I'm going to click Yes. Next, I get a window that asked me if I want to move everything from the old location, which was on the C drive, to the new location. The answer to that, of course, is yes. In my example for this video, I was actually setting up a computer that I had sold to a customer and there was nothing in the C drive contacts folder. But that doesn't matter. I'm still going to say yes. There will be a little pause and then the contacts property window will disappear. I want to show you one more example at a slow speed. This time, I'm going to right-click on Desktop. Once again, I'm going to go to Properties, and when Properties comes up, I'm going to find the Location tab. Again, in the Location field, I'm going to change the letter C to, in my case, the letter E. You would again use whatever letter is assigned to your secondary drive. Next, I'm going to click OK, which you can't see on the screen. Then I choose Yes when the pop-up asks me about creating the folder. Of course, I also select Yes when I'm asked if I want to move from the old location to the new one. At this point, I'm going to speed through the other folder location changes. Feel free to enjoy the background music. Finally, we're down to the OneDrive folder. When we right-click and then choose Properties, we find that there is no Location tab. That's because you cannot change the location of OneDrive the same way we changed the others. What you would need to do is set the location when you initially set up OneDrive. That's how you change the location of the OneDrive instead of doing it here, since that option doesn't exist. Let's double-check our work. Opening the E drive, we click on Users. And then Beverly. Sure enough, there are all our folders. Great! We've learned how to change the location of our folders so we can save space on the smaller C drive.
That's it for this video. I'm John Grubb from 4KCC.com. I hope that you've subscribed to our channel and that you will like this video and share it with other people. Please come visit us again, and thanks.